Designing a base map, part 8, finalizing the poster. In the previous video, you learned about cartographic typography. In this video, you will choose a map theme and finalize your poster. Choose one of the following map themes. You can choose the historical fire damage from the 1906 earthquake as the theme, or you can pick sea level rise and flooding. Use your theme as a keyword and download the shapefile from the DataSF website. Save the file to your original folder and decompress the file. Refresh your original folder and rename the shapefile. When done, add the data to the map document. Edit the color and symbology so that your chosen theme is easily distinguished from the base map. In a previous tutorial, you learned how to create a map poster by inserting map elements and labels. Using what you learned, finalize the poster layout. Incorporate a title for the poster above the map. You may use a decorative typeface if appropriate. To the right of the map, use the rectangle text tool on the draw toolbar to provide a block of descriptive text. You may search the internet for appropriate text. If your theme is sea level rise, the metadata on the DataSF website might also be helpful. If your theme is fire damage from the 1906 earthquake, the USGS has a webpage that might interest you. Links are provided on the written instructions. In the margins around the map, include a north arrow, a scale bar, a representative fraction, and a word statement. The last two can be found on the Insert menu under Scale Text. Your map legend does not need a title, but should include all of the layers except for the shoreline. For each layer, open the Properties window and navigate to the General tab. Clean up the labels for the layers by removing any underscores. The layer names are what will appear in the map legend, and you want to avoid underscores on the final map. Add an acknowledgement to datasf.org at the bottom of the poster. Also, include your name and the year. When you are done creating your map poster, export the map as a PDF file with a resolution of at least 300 dpi. Save it to your final folder.